education. I am a design specialist from SSAB. And for those that never have heard about SSAB, SSAB is the biggest water manufacturer of high-speed steel. And those that never have heard about SSAB, perhaps you have heard about Hardox, Strix, Domex, and Domo, our steel brands. I will tell a little bit about trailer development, chassis development, and how we are trying to help the customers to make this upgrade. Before I start, I must explain why someone from the steel market is here to tell for you about trailers and chassis. Because we, since the beginning, more than 30 years ago, SSAB decided to create a group to help the customers to use this steel in the best way. And this group is called Knowledge Dev Center. We are working in Sweden, and we are not developing new steels. We are working to help customers with these projects. So we work with planes, trailers, trucks, pickers, all kinds of projects from our customers. So regarding trailer development, since the beginning, we can see year after year how trailers have been developed. We can see in the tires, we can see in the dashboard of the truck. Also, engines are becoming year after year powerful, higher torque, and less emissions. We can see transmission as well. Transmission has been developed year after year. And in the steel, unfortunately for us, we cannot make the steel looks better, looks nice. The steel looks the same for 100 years, 200 years. In order to know that the steel is better, is evolving, we must go into the steel, check the properties, microstructure. So, regarding grades, we have had in the beginning minus steel grades, and then later high strength steel grades, as they used to call in the 80s, and then after advanced high strength steel, and nowadays ultra high strength steel. Advanced high strength steels are those steels with 700 megapascal in yield strength. Ultra high strength steels are the grades with 960 megapascal in the grades in the yield strength. How we are seeing the use of steel in the trailers, in the chassis? As you can see, in the 60s, we had a not so wide portfolio of steels. All our factories, they were forced to use mild steels. Then later, the steel mills tried to develop high-strength steels, and the portfolio was a little bit bigger. In the year 2000, we have a much wider portfolio. And what we have seen, we are predicting for 2020 and 2040, is that trailer manufacturers, they will keep upgrading the chassis materials. They will keep trying to make lighter structures that can carry more load. If we remove 1 ton, 2 tons from the chassis, from the trailer, it means that we can have 1 ton, 2 tons more in that load. So we are worried with this upgrade for the next years. Why we know that it will happen? If we are discussing about emissions, this is the European Commission target for greenhouse gas emissions for 2030. They would like to have 40% in gas regarding levels from 1990. And I will show you how things are now in Germany, for example. These are the greenhouse emissions in Germany for 9 seconds. As you can see, in the 90, we have the first level. And here, in the gray, 2020 and then 2030. It seems that it should be hard to reach, but we can see that they are in the way. The problem is that we have here 9 segments. 8 segments are doing well. They are reducing the greenhouse gas emissions. Only one segment is having higher values than in 90. And this segment is transport. Transport is the only segment that is not making possible to reduce the greenhouse gas emissions. This is why we believe that the transport segment must keep upgrading and making lighter products. How it works, the upgrade? If we take a mild steel I-beam, that's the most common structure engineering, and then we upgrade this I-beam for 700 grade, we can have a new I-beam 22% lighter and 44% stronger. It means that we are giving to the customer a lighter trailer with a safety factor 40% higher. We know that in some countries,